Well, hello, old dearies. It's me, Agnes Smith, Nomadic Fanatic's number one fan. Eric booked it through several states to get back to Arizona to unpack his precious Mickey Mouse collection. Let's watch.
Hey guys, I am going to travel multiple states and 2,400 miles, but through the magic of video editing, here I am. You would think that a 2,400-mile trip would be the perfect opportunity to capture traveling footage. Oh well. It was a rough 12 hours, but I managed to pack all my crap into my storage shed that is uninsulated and unprotected from rodents that will undoubtedly burrow into it for shelter during the winter. I have bad news about Reba the Rebel, the junk motorcycle that I bought on a whim for $600. After extensive work, it looks like she can't be fixed. I guess it will have to be stored with the other useless junk in the shed. I'm here on my property, and it may not look like it now, but one day I will have my own magical kingdom, a moat to keep the bad people out, and the biggest hot tub you have ever seen. However, I have no intention of working on my property right now because it will be too cold and I would rather be in the south chasing 70-degree weather. It's so nice that Kemper Van Kemper is letting me keep my things on his property for free. After Tater Tot had a flat, I have decided to keep a full-size spare tire, jack, and lug wrench in a trunk. Why can't I keep these things in my RV? Well, there's a very good reason for that. Bye, guys.
Oh, I think Eric's idea of a beautiful kingdom of his own is wonderful. I imagine all of his friends will be there with him in that gigantic Mickey Mouse-shaped hot tub, eating Tater Tot casserole and Dr. Pepper pulled pork sandwiches. Although it's sad that Reba couldn't be fixed, I'm sure she will have plenty of friends to keep her company during the winter. Have a blessed day, old dearies, from Nomadic Fanatics number one fan.